Okay, I did a video about the unit circle and I just filled in the top right quadrant. People have asked me to do the rest of it, so I guess here we go. Here's a way to remember the unit circle, or a couple tricks to at least help you along the way. Again, the unit circle is a circle of radius 1, so this is 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, we're just plotting points. Everybody can do this. Negative 1, 0, and 0, negative 1. Okay, and remember that the circumference of a circle is 2 pi times its radius. Well, the unit circle has radius 1, so we'll just get 2 pi times 1, or simply 2 pi. We measure angles again from the positive x-axis, and we measure positive angles counterclockwise. So that means the distance around the circle is 2 pi. Again, people, you know, if you turn around on a skateboard, you don't do a 2 pi radians, you do a 360. Okay, so 360 degrees is equivalent to 2 pi. Okay, so if we go the entire way around the circle, we'll go from 0 degrees to equivalently 2 pi degrees. Well, half of 2 pi would be pi radians. I said degrees, 0, 2 pi degrees. That's wrong. It's pi radians. 0 and 2 pi radians. Excuse me there. I was thinking about skateboarding. So pi radians, that's going to correspond to the point negative 1, 0, because when we're over at an angle of pi, or equivalently 180 degrees, we're at negative 1, 0. Okay, so let me speed through this a little faster. Pi over 2, 3 pi over 2 at the bottom. And think about it. It's 0, 1 pi over 2, 2 pi over 2, which is pi, 3 pi over 2, 4 pi over 2, which is 2 pi. Okay, if you take this and cut it, the first quadrant in half, okay, well, between pi over 2, the angle 0 and pi over 2, that must be pi over 4. Why did I write down 3? Having a bad day today. So pi over 4, 2 pi over 4, which is pi over 2, and then 3 pi over 4. It's a problem, I was thinking about this one. We'll get 3 pi over 4 as being that angle. 4 pi over 4, down in the bottom left, we'll get 5 pi over 4. This will be the angle 5 pi. Let me erase my circumference stuff. This will be the angle 5 pi over 4. 6 pi over 4, which is 3 pi over 2, or 7 pi over 4. After that, you'll be back again at 8 pi over 4, or 2 pi. Okay, so we can do the same thing with the smaller angle. This is pi over 6. Well, that's equivalently 30 degrees. Take 180 and divide it by 6. You get 30 degrees. 60 degrees will actually be somewhere up here. 60 degrees, though, is going to correspond to pi divided by 3. So, okay, so the other angle over here, if this is pi over 6, if we go all the way around, that's 6 pi over 6, but we go a little bit less. So this will be the angle 5 pi over 6. Likewise, 6 pi over 6 a little bit further will be 7 pi over 6. And likewise, if we go all the way around, we'll be at 12 pi over 6, or 2 pi, but we go one less, so if we go just a little bit less, well, that'll put us at the angle 11 pi over 6. Okay, so my picture's getting a little cluttered, but that's what's going to happen. Pi over 3, 2 pi over 3 is going to be up here in this quadrant. So here's the angle 2 pi over 3. 3 pi over 3 will put you at the x-axis, negative part of the x-axis. 4 pi over 3 will be down here. So 4 pi over 3. 5 pi over 3 is going to be over here. Okay, so the angle 5 pi over 3. Okay, all we have to do now is fill in the values that go everywhere. Okay, let's do this. Again, I think I showed in the last video this trick. The way that you can remember the points that go with pi over 3, pi over 4, and pi over 6, this isn't a negative, just a little dash. So make fractions over 2, over 2, over 2, over 2, over 2, over 2. Write 1, 2, 3 down, 1, 2, 3 up. And then you take the square roots of all the tops. Well, the square root of 1 is 1, the square root of 3, square root of 2, square root of 2, square root of 3, the square root of 1 is 1. So those are the points on the unit circle that go with the angle pi over 3, pi over 4, and the angle pi over 6. This is the point on the unit circle, square root of 3 over 2, comma, 1 half. Well, okay, to get the others, if you know pi over 6, you know 5 pi over 6. The values are the same, except the only thing that changes here is the x-coordinate's now negative, so it'll be negative root 3 over 2, comma, 1 half. 7 pi over 6, it's the same values, except now they'll both be negative, so negative square root of 3 over 2, comma, negative 1 half. Back over here at 11 pi over 6, the x-coordinate will be positive, so it'll be positive square root of 3 over 2, comma, negative 1 half. Okay, so now we know all the values that go with basically the denominators of 6, and you can do the same little argument to fill in the rest of the circle here. Let me zoom out here real quick. Whoops. Okay, so the value that goes with pi over 4 over here at 3 pi over 4 by symmetry, this will be just the negative of the x-coordinate, negative root 2 over 2, comma square root of 2 over 2. Down here at the bottom, they'll both be negative, so negative root 2 over 2, comma negative root 2 over 2. In the bottom right quadrant, the x-coordinate will be positive, negative root 2 over 2, but the y-coordinate will be negative. And you can do the same thing with pi over 3. Just like it was 1 half root 3 over 2, up here at the top it'll be negative 1 half root 3 over 2. In the bottom left, they'll both be negative, so negative 1 half, negative root 3 over 2. And in the bottom right, the x-coordinate will be positive, root 3 over 2. Whoops, I'm looking at the wrong place now. 1 half, comma, negative root 3 over 2, because that one will be negative. Whew. All right, there's my gory-looking unit circle. I hope it makes sense. I think I'm probably out of time, so I hope it helps.